फ्रेंड्स, सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द एसएफडी डायग्राम एंड बीएमडी डायग्राम फॉर ए पोर्टल मींस फॉर एनी फ्रेम्स. ओके, सो हाउ टू ड्रॉ द एसएफडी एंड बीएमडी फॉर द फ्रेम. सो इट्स लाइक अ गिवन प्रॉब्लम टू अस दैट एल लेंथ एंड एल लेंथ, बीम एंड कॉलम्स एंड पी लोड इज अप्लाइड एट द एंड. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी हैव टू सी इन द गोल्डन रूल्स टू ड्रॉ एसएफडी. मीन्स एसएफडी डायग्राम हम कैसे बनाएंगे, तो उसके कुछ रूल्स है. देयर आर सम रूल्स दैट विल हेल्प इन ड्रॉ द एसएफडी डायग्राम. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू हैव टू चूज द रेफरेंस फेस. रेफरेंस फेस मीन्स लाइक हेयर यू कैन सी टू साइड्स बिकॉज कॉलम हैव टू साइड्स, लेफ्ट एंड राइट. सो यू कैन चूज द राइट साइड एज द रेफरेंस एंड यू कैन चूज द लेफ्ट साइड एज द रेफरेंस. ओके, लेफ्ट साइड मीन्स आउट आउटवर्ड द कॉलम एंड सेम फॉर बीम्स. बीम्स मीन्स आउटवर्ड द कॉलम. ओके, सो यू कैन कंसिडर द आउटसाइड एज ए रेफरेंस प्लेन, रेफरेंस फेस. एंड देर इज सेकेंड केस ऑल्सो दैट इन विच यू कैन कंसिडर द रेफरेंस फेस एज इनर साइड ऑफ द फ्रेम. ओके, सो दिस इज द मीनिंग ऑफ रेफरेंस फेस. नाउ वी गो ऑन सेकेंड पॉइंट. राइट शियर फोर्स एट एनी सेक्शन बाई कंसिडरिंग रोटेशन ऑफ एलिमेंट क्लॉकवाइज एज पॉजिटिव. मीन्स सो इट विल बी easier to buy the problem, I think. So this is the first point that we have to focus on, that reference phase. So now we go on our problem. So this is our problem, the same problem I have taken from last phase. So this is the length L and L. So first of all we have to calculate the reactions. How many reactions are developed right here? So this is the fixed support. So here you can say there are three number of reactions. Means first is our moment, second is our, so I take it here. Okay, first is our reaction in next axis. You know it's not some, there is not any compact. So this is our ry, not any confusion in it, rx, and this is the rz. Okay, so there are three types of unknowns. So what are the values? So you have to just use the equilibrium equation, summation fx is equal to 0. Here you can get rx is equal to 0 because there is not any force in x direction in our structure. So rx is equal to 0, same. Summation fy 0 means positive y direction force is equal to negative y direction force. So positive y direction is equal to ry and negative means, in the negative means downward. Downward is, I am taking it as negative and upward as positive. Okay, so downward is P. So ry is equal to P. You can get it easily because this is so simple. M z is equal to 0 about which, so I am taking about the A. So you have to clockwise moment at single side and other side as anti-clockwise moment. So clockwise moment is clockwise moment because at A point I am write the moment equation for point A. So the P load is generate a clockwise moment of P into L because the perpendicular distance from the A of P loading is L, because perpendicular distance is L for the loading of P. Okay, so P into L is the moment that is in clockwise direction. So clockwise is right in left portion, means LSS. Now the anticlockwise moment is rz. We have taken it as rz. So rz is equal to pl. Okay, there is not any other moment that will be developed at point A. So these are the unknowns that we get. So now we have to, so this is the first part we have done. This is the basic part that we have to do at every time for analyzing a structure. The unknown find. So now go to the second part. Second part is what? We have to select the reference base. What the part, second part? Select means choose. Choose the reference face. So now I choose the outside. Okay, there are two options I have told you on the last slide. So I am taking as outside as the reference face. Okay, outside as the reference face. So outside I am taking at the reference face. So now First of all, we draw the SFD diagram for the portal frame for this frame. So first of all, I draw the SFD. I draw the SFD. Okay, so this is our question statement, means question diagram, and these are the unknown that we get. This is P, and here is a one moment of P into L. Okay, so now I have taken as the outside as reference face. Outside as reference face. So what I have written in last page for the shear force diagram, what is that? Write shear force at any section by considering rotation. Okay, we have to check the rotation of element clockwise as positive. If the rotation of the element by the loading is clockwise at that section, then we have to take on the positive shear force at that force. So what is the significance of that point? So I do it at here. So let us take this section as our section of interest. Okay, so what is the shear force at X? What is the shear force at XX? There is any shear force or not? So there is not any shear force because there is not any transverse loading of the to the column. Transverse loading, the summation of the transverse loading is our shear force, but there is not any transverse loading to column. So shear force at XX is equal to 0. Okay, so now XX move from left from bottom to right, bottom to top, means A to B. So A to B, the shear force is equal to remains 0. Now we go on this section XX. Okay, we go on this section XX. So now we are taking the section in the BC beam. So let us take this is our XX. So from left to right. Okay. So this is the beam. So now I cut it in the right portion. This is our B. This is our C. This is XX and this is P loading. Okay, this is A and this is P into L. So now shear force at XX for the BC beam. For what? For the BC beam. So when I go left to right, then what is the force? You have to just see this portion, because left of the portion of XX. So what is the transverse loading? Transverse loading is P. In which direction? In positive direction. So what is the shear force is equal to P. Okay, shear force is equal to P, and if I go from 0 to L, means B to C. So at C, shear force at C. What is the shear force at C? Because there is a upward loading of P, means positive P. And now I go to the C point and I see that there is a loading of P in downward direction, so that will be negative P. So what is the shear force at C? That is equal to 0. So we can get the shear force at each portion. Each portion means in the segment of AB and in the segment of BC. So I will take some more examples. So there is nothing to worry about anything. So I draw the SFD now. Now what are we doing? We are drawing the SFD. So we know all the values of shear force and shear force at each segment. So what is the rule? So we just go to the rule, write the shear force, the rotation of clockwise as positive. So what we have seen, you see that because the shear force of the beam, we can do easily. What is the shear force and shear force at XX? So what is the meaning of that rotation? What is the meaning of that rotation of element clockwise as positive? So what is the meaning of this? Meaning of this, that if, so I am taking another example that is like this. If the loading P and the section is this, so what is the rotation? Because I cut the section at xx from x distance, then at this section it will create a anti-clockwise moment. Anti-clockwise moment means anti-clockwise rotation. What is this? This is create a anti-clockwise rotation, means if the anti-clockwise rotation is there, just and we have to take the positive forward, positive for the clockwise rotation, and we get negative rotation error. So what is the shear force? Shear force is negative P, because we don't need of any rotation at air, because the column loading, there is not any shear force in the column, but in the beam we get the shear force, and that is easy for us because we have done the beams SFD BMD already. So this is easier for us. And if the column has this type of casing, then we have to take the rotation part. What the rotation? If clockwise, then we have to take the positive. And if anti-clockwise at the section, then we have to take the negative. This is the meaning of that line. Okay. So now we are drawing the SFD diagram for this case. So what is the shear force at any section on column? What is this? Zero. So this is zero. So the line go in this way. This is zero. Now from B to C. B to C, what is the value? B to C is equal to P. But at the C point, that is equal to zero. Positive means, so positive we have to take. Now the V third point is used. So positive we have to plot it on the reference face side. And negative shear force is plotted on the opposite side. So in the reference, and where is the reference? Outside. So positive from outside, positive on outside and negative on inside. So positive, we have the value of positive P. So positive V in what face? In the outside face. That is like P value at here. That is same from here to here, and sudden draw down. Sudden drawdown by zero, because at the C point there is loading, means there is zero shear force. So that is zero, and that is our positive P. So this is the SFD diagram for this case, because first of all we have to just know that how to draw the SFD of BMD and SFD BMD of frames. So I have taken the simple example for that. Now go to the BMD diagram. So the rules are same. First of all, reference face, that is I like, we can take same as outside, and write the bending moment at any section by considering moment producing compression at the reference face as positive. So we have to take the positive bending moment for what? If it will create a compression on the reference face. If the moment will produce compression on the reference face, then we have to take the bending moment as positive. So what is the meaning of that? So we see that how to draw. So I cut it and go to the new page. Okay, so now first of all we take the section AB. AB means column part. So in the column, if section is XX, then if the section is XX, then we can see that there is loading P and anti-clockwise moment PL, and this, that is our XX, and the distance is X. Okay, so what is the moment at X? You can tell me easily, because there is not any transverse loading by which the moment will create any transverse loading. Because there is not any transverse, then moment will be zero by any loading. But there is a support reaction, that is already a moment. And what is negative PL? We can't say negative positive, because this is the anti-clockwise. So if anti-clockwise moment will apply here, then the bending will like this. So bending will go like this, you know, because if the anti-clockwise moment at air, that is equal to PL, then the our column will deflect like this, and that is what. And we have taken the reference face as outside. So this is the outside reference face. And this is like gone like this. So this is the compression or tension on the reference face. You can easily tell, because the reference face will stretch. If it will stretch, then this is tension. So what is the moment? Moment is equal to negative because we have to take the positive bending moment. No, there, second point. If it will create produce compression moment at that point, that section, then it will be positive bend moment. And here that is producing positive tension parts, so it will take in negative sign. Okay, so the what is the value of this? Negative of PL. So moment at SX mean in AB column, that will be same throughout the column. Okay, now we go to the next part. Next part for what? In BC. So beam, we have to take the section. So as I told you that you can take left hand side and right hand side. So I take it as left hand side, as we have taken in shear force already, that is same. So this is the case. Okay, so what is the, this is our x distance. Now what is the moment at x by this loading? So P will create a moment of what? It's go like up, so like up, and it will create like this type of moment. Okay, this type of moment at this section. If I will apply the P load, then it will go up and it will deflect like this. And we have chosen the reference face as outside. So what is the, so it's compress the reference face. This loading will compress the reference face. So what we have to take, positive or negative? If it will compress, then we have to take it as positive part. So MXX is equal to what? P into X distance, that will producing the compression on the reference face. So we have to take the positive for the reference face, and what is the moment? P into X. And there is any other moment also? Yes, there is any other moment of P into L, but it will anticlockwise. So if we'll put at here anticlockwise, if I put it at here, then anticlockwise will deflect like this, and the meaning of this is tension. It will produce the tension in reference phase. Then we have to take the negative. Negative of what? PL. So this is the bending equations for our section. So by it we can say easily, if at x is equal to 0 means at point B, what is the moment? What is the moment? Moment at B is equal to, we have to just put at x is equal to 0. So 0 minus PL, that is come out as negative of PL. And x is equal to L, that is our C point. So what is the moment? P into L, and PL is already there, so that will come out at 0. So just we have all the values for bending moments. Now we have to just draw the bending moment diagram for this case. So this is our frame. This is our frame and the bending moment at A. So what is the bending moment at A? We can say easily, because throughout the AB column there is one bending moment, that is equal to negative of PL. So now we have to draw the negative bending moment at where? And the opposite side. That the same as shear force. That will same means positive bending moment is plotted on the reference face side and negative bending moment is plotted on the opposite side. So that the rule is same. So now we have to just draw the BMD diagram for this. So value is negative PL means the reference face is outside. Reference face is outside, but that value is in negative. So negative will be drawn in inside, means opposite of the reference face. So that is same, because throughout the column the value is same, as we know. So that is equal to negative of PL. Okay, now in the BC what? At the B, because the point B is at here and C is at here and A is at here. So at B point the moment is equal to minus PL, that should, so negative PL, but the reference phase is upside, so we have to take the downside. For the beam BC, there is reference phase is upper of the BC, but the value will come out as negative, so negative we have to take downward. So from here, so what is the value? PL. And at the C point, that will be 0. So this is 0 at point C. Okay, this is also negative part because we have drawn in opposite to the reference face side. Okay, so this is our bending moment diagram for this case.